When I moved into this place, I had barged across a spinet piano. I paid $50 for it. I got a little bitty barge out there, and I had a Volkswagen van, and I brought it in the back. We were very low in the water, and the captain of the barge said, "How come we're so low? What you got in there, a piano?" And of course, when we hit the beach, I popped open the back of my Volkswagen van, and there was a piano in there. So I moved in with a $50 piano and a golden retriever and some hand tools and a sleeping bag. Yeah. And on that $50 piano, I finished, on that very piano, I finished Omani Mysterium.
Morten Lauridsen seems to me one of the few living composers who I would call great. He is one of the few composers who I have conviction will be performed 100, 200 years from now. His music has a kind of authority as well as a beauty. He seems to recapitulate the entire history of Western choral music in his compositions, which still seem fresh and contemporary. He is, I think there's no other word for it, a genius.
Sure, on this shining night, very pantheistic poem, feeling at one with nature and the wondrous awe that one has in being within nature. And certainly on a shining night, I experience those on my island so often, on Walden Island, and you feel at one with nature and the world.
There was this one chord that he played that I will never forget. That's when I went, oh my God, I'm in the presence of greatness.
Morten Lauridsen's music, it's all over the world now. And that to me is something that all Americans, I guess, can be proud of.
Das erste Mal, dass ich meine Begegnung mit Morten Lauridsen gemacht habe, I listened to this music and I was completely thrilled. I never heard in my life such beautiful music.
Great mystery. Life's a mystery.
I'm right on the water. I'm looking west. I'm looking towards Canada on Cowlitz Bay. This is the greatest thing that ever happened to me in my whole life.